the way to Birmingham City University Extra Mile Awards. There's a few people up for nomination, so good luck to everybody. We're gonna smash it, it's gonna be amazing.
Excellent ambassador for nursing in BCU, wow. And an outstanding nurse leader, and then a future clinical leader. Highly commended for Inspirational Student of the Year is... I was expecting you. Thank you, it gives me great pleasure to present Debbie Brennan.
Yeah!
Professional services staff members to help with both students and their colleagues. Here are the finalists. Highly commended is... Bernadette O'Brien.
Skills and employability of their students. Here are the finalists. Our highly commended teacher is...
Students to become the best marketeers and to actually create the best people that we can from BCU. So I love BCU and I love the students and I'm so honoured. Thank you.
Bit of an upgrade on venue from last year, the Enterprising Student of the Year Award is an opportunity to recognise the students for their entrepreneurial achievements. putting the skills from their degree to work by setting up their own business or other enterprise. Here are the finalists. Highly commended as Enterprising Student of the Year is Daryl Blake.
Go on, Daryl. And they need someone to make them believe in themselves, or if they need a shoulder to cry on, their personal teacher is the person they will turn to. Here are our finalists.
Seems to fall behind in these awards, and also to thank the Dean of the Faculty, Professor David Roberts, who's stepping down as Dean for his support. Also colleagues in the School of English, Peter Cameron from the Press Office, who's managed to make English literature make French. BC can keep research at the very top of the university's agenda, but also research that matters to the public and that's relevant. Thank you so much.
Good evening. Our student representatives are an important link between the university students and staff. The winner of this award will be friendly and approachable and provide valuable advice and support to their fellow students. Here are the finalists. Our highly commended student representative is Kathy Zoe Byra.
And the winner of the award is MD Fan.
Good evening. Oh. I'm amazing to receive this award. It's a fire year. And obviously I would like to say thanks to all the people especially my school reps today, Deborah, and my other colleagues of the school reps, and also my society members of the county societies, and also the SALs I've worked with in all these years. So thanks a lot for this all.
Yeah. And how good are these guys over here on the left-hand side? Okay, so brilliant volunteers make a huge impact on university life. No matter what the setting, the winner of this award will be using their energy, commitment, and team working skills to make a difference. So here are the finalists. Give these guys a round of applause. The highly commended student volunteer is Gibson. Shannon Barnard.
The winner of the award is Rachel Smith.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Team of the Year award recognises the university's great teams. Groups of staff and students working to organise events, run projects, and to make a positive difference to life at Birmingham City University. Who are the finalists? The highly commended team of the year is the BLSS Student Success Award.
Have a team. They couldn't make it tonight, so I'm reckoning for all of us. But yes, thank you to everyone who voted for us. Thank you to our boss, Liz, who continues to be an amazing base of support for us all. Thank you to our programme teams in our schools, who again are massively supportive. And ultimately, thank you to the students, because they are the ones who we're here for, and they're the ones who we do this job for. Thank you.
And the winner of the Team of the Year award is the CV Induction Hack Team.
Well, thank you very much. We had, didn't think we had any chance of winning, so I haven't really got anything to say. So there is more of the team, but unfortunately they couldn't make it here tonight. There's two more. What I didn't say also is most of these guys here were also placement students, apart from Liam on the end, so that makes it even better. But thank you very much for everybody voting for us, and hopefully we'll get more notice next year if we have to do it again. So thank you.
I think before I say something, it's a very personal story. So what happened during induction talks, Lucky came up to myself and said, Jasper, I'm gonna give induction talk to about 250 students, and I'm really nervous. Can you come with me? And I'm so proud that she today hosted this. Well done, Lucky. Keep it up. And it's so great, especially congratulations to all the winners, and congratulations to all the finalists as well. You've done some fantastic work, and that's the reason why we are here to celebrate. And so before I say, the winner of Vice Chancellor and Student Union President's Award, as you would have heard about the person already, the person has not only helped the student, the societies within the Students' Union or various groups within the university, plus she's helped the groups which are out of the university, and the extra mile is she has set up her own charity, and which is amazing, and I'm so proud to present the Vice Chancellor and Student Union President Award to Rachel Smith. Congratulations.
Thanks so much. I really love what to say. This is pretty cool. If you can go on and look at Wounded Healing on Facebook or something, it's just if people are in the first steps of mental health, like to try and help them going to the doctors and stuff like that. So if I'm going to make a speech, I might get about wounded healing. And I really need some support at the moment because it's just in the first stages. So yeah, if you can go on and have a look at that. But yeah, thank you guys. Thank you so much.
Imagine how tough this was for the judges looking at the main awards. But how can you judge between inspirational lecturers, outstanding researchers, brilliant personal tutors, great teams of staff, all the people that we've had represented here this evening? It really is almost an impossible choice. And I guess what for both Jazz and I this came down to was the idea of the extra mile. And within the university, we're a huge university, we have a huge portfolio, we have 24,000 students. And the sad reality of life in any complex organisation is that sometimes stuff goes wrong. And where we stand up, where our values show, where our student focus shows, is how we respond to that challenge. And too often it's really easy, and it's easy at my end of things as well, point the finger and go, that's somebody else's fault, nothing we can do. I'm sorry if people are not going to have a brilliant experience, but frankly, it was nothing to do with me. And the reason that Jazz and I felt that we wanted to give the award in the way that we did was it recognised an extra mile spirit that said, something's gone wrong, we're going to put it right. And having put it right in such an astonishingly clever way, representing not just their own talent, but also a huge amount of hard work, that it's become something that actually becomes part of our portfolio, becomes part of the way that we do things. So I'd like a drum roll. Last one of the evening, I promise. But I'd like to give the award to the CB Level 4 induction hack team. I can safely conclude they weren't expecting this.
Speech just doesn't quite go far enough. Thank you very much for everybody who voted for us. And like I say, there's loads of people who are involved. This is just some of the core team tonight. But there were hundreds of people involved. There was nearly 700 students we had to deal with. 400 students at very short notice, 2 weeks' notice, with no rooms or anything. So thank you to everybody who helped out. And thank you very much.
Is thank you all for being a part of this year's Extra Mile Awards. I hope you have all enjoyed your evening so far, and I'm sure you want to join me in a round of applause for all of tonight's finalists and winners. Just to end things off, I'd like to give a personal shout out to the Extra Mile Awards team. So, Yasmin Chander, Lisa Burton, Laura Dudley, Philip Gillingham, Samuel Grant, and also Michael Gale hiding behind the doors over there. Can we give them all a big round of applause? I'd also like to say that I'm very happy and humbled and blessed to have been able to host this event. I go back to my course. Unfortunately, I go back to being a second year student in September this year. Yeah, I know. Back to the School of English, so shout out to School of English, everyone. But I finished my end of term at the end of June, and I'd just like to say it's been a massive, great opportunity to be your Vice President. So food and drink is now available outside, so please go and enjoy yourselves. And also, could I ask that all of tonight's winners and highly commended nominees, along with the award presenters, join me here on stage. So I can make a few photos. Thank you, everyone.